Good morning and happy Sabbath. So, the first song that we're going to be opening with today is called Create in Me. And in Psalms 51, verse 10, David said, "Create in me a clean heart. O God, renew a loyal spirit within me."
Create in me a clean, clean heart. Create in me, O work of God. Create in me a miracle.
Oh, thank you so much. That was so good. Amen. Welcome, everybody, especially to Milo. You guys look fabulous and you sound fabulous. Amen. We are so happy that you're here. Welcome. Welcome. We're a little bit sorry today because we're a little bit low. We've got a lot of sickness running around, and we didn't know this when we invited you guys to come, but over at Roseburg, our kids from RCA are doing a program today. So we're missing a few for different reasons. But those of us who are here are really going to enjoy. Amen? We're going to enjoy it. I'm going to do the sound man a favor. And I'm going to say something I probably shouldn't, but I'm going to do it so that Mike is happy, because I'm married to that guy back there, and I like to keep him happy. So, so to help with the feedback problem, don't hold your mic down here. You got to hold it up like this, all right? Because if you feel like you're too loud, he'll take care of it. But if it's down like this, he's going to try to be turning you up, and it's going to get really feedbacky, okay? Is that cool? You're doing awesome. All right. All right. Well, welcome. We're so glad that you're here. I have a few announcements this morning, and then it's going to be the end of me, and you get to see these guys for the rest of the morning. Just a couple of things. Bible study's coming up this week on Tuesday night. That's at 6 if you want to come early and have some prayer, 6:30, and they're studying the book of John this Tuesday evening. Also, leadership has a meeting on Thursday night on the 18th, 7 p.m. for the majority of us, and 6 o'clock for elders' meetings. We have something special happening on April 20th at 6 p.m. right here at Turning Point. Our former pastor, Lonnie, has gotten remarried, and Lonnie and Rose are having a reception here at Turning Point, and they would love it if you would come, but you need to RSVP so that they know how many people to expect. All right? All right, our offering focus today is for Hope Channel, and so that's if you want your offerings or your tithes to go there this morning, be sure that you mark that on an envelope. All right, I want to read a scripture to you today, and these guys are going to sing an awesome offering song in a second, right? Am I correct? Okay, cool. Don't they look good? They look so good. Woohoo! All right, Psalm 66. Shout for joy to God, all the earth. Sing the glory of his name and make his praise glorious. Say to God, how awesome are your deeds. So great is your power that your enemies cringe before you. All the earth bows down to you. They sing praise to you. They sing the praises of your name. Verse 16. Come and hear, all you who fear God, and let me tell you what he has done for me. I think that Milo is going to share some cool things with us about what God's been doing with them, and they're going to share their talents with us, and we're just super blessed this morning. Let's bow our heads for a little prayer. Lord Jesus, we're so grateful to be in your presence on your day with so many of your family, so many of your children. Lord, we have some guests in our house today, and we're so pleased that they're with us, but they're not guests to you. You know them full well. And Lord, I just pray that you'd give them peace. I pray that you'd give them a clarity and ability as they share with us what you have on your heart today, that you would work through them and in them to speak to your people today and anoint them for the purposes set before them today. Lord, I pray the rest of us would have ears to hear and hearts that are soft and leaning towards you to hear what you would have to say. We honor you, Lord. We praise you because you're worthy of it. And we love you with all our hearts. Be glorified in this house today, in Jesus' name, and Lord, bless the offering. Amen.
Full of broken dreams. Wow, guys, there's so many stories in the Bible, but I feel like no one really talks about them anymore.
You know, yeah, there is a lot of stories in the Bible, like the story of Abraham, Noah, Isaac, Jacob.
Oh, there's Joseph. Why don't we talk about Joseph?
Well, yeah, we could talk about him, but there's not much that we really know about him before Mary, besides that he was a carpenter and all.
No, silly, the other Joseph.
Wait, there's another Joseph?
Yeah, from the other Testament.
Wait, there's another Testament?
I did not know that.
Listen to the narrator.
Jacob had 12 sons, and his favorite was a guy named Joseph, because he had him in his old age. He loved Joseph so much that he made him this beautiful coat. Not just any coat, it was a technicolor coat.
Wait, why did you just say a rainbow coat?
Can you imagine a father giving his son a rainbow coat?
Good point.
Hey, yeah. Son, look what I got you. I got you a rainbow coat. You know you're my favorite, right?
Oh. Hey, Dad. How's that limp treating you? Where'd you say that you got this? From, like, a war or something?
Nah. I got it from wrestling. Anyways, do you like the coat I got for you? My favorite son?
You sure you didn't get this, like, for Mom or something?
No. I got it for you, my favorite son. I could not only choose one color, my favorite son. Did I mention you're my favorite son?
Yeah, multiple times. You really shouldn't have picked. You should have just picked one color.
No. My favorite son. Just try it on. Just try it on.
Okay.
Wow. Would you look at that? It looks so nice. How do you like it?
It kind of looks like some Care Bears threw up on you.
It's beautiful.
It was known by the brothers that Joseph was indeed the favorite. They weren't very happy about the situation, and Joseph didn't help matters much by telling them his dreams.
Hey, what's up, bro? I'm just wearing the coat here. Hey, did I tell you? I had a dream.
What, that you died?
Don't be ridiculous. No. It was that you guys, like, bowing down to me, and I was like, yeah, you are. And what do you think of that?
This is what I think.
And that is what they thought. In fact, the brothers were so angry with Joseph that they had a how to get rid of Joseph meeting with everyone present except Joseph.
All right, the how to get rid of Joseph meeting with everyone except Joseph can now come to order.
Why are we talking in British accents?
Everyone in the Bible speaks with a British accent.
Oh, right.
All righty. Does anybody have any ideas about how we can get rid of our brother? Anyone?
Why don't we feed him to the wolves?
I like how you think, but see, I think we've got to do something a little less rated R, a little more PG-13. I know. How about we sell him as a slave?
Right. I rip that flashy coat of his and get some blood from a goat. Yeah.
And that is exactly what they did. The brothers thought that they got rid of him. But here's the thing. When God has a vision, nothing can stop it. Satan wanted to use Joseph's brother to destroy him. But God, in his majestic wisdom, turned Satan's wrongdoings into something that could, into the best thing that could ever happen to the Hebrew nation. Through Joseph, God saved his family from famine. In return, God made Joseph second in command. God had a plan for Joseph, like he has a plan for you.
Thank you. Serve You, Lord. That's because it was Milo's theme song last year to accompany our theme of serving one another in love. This year's theme is Let Go and Let God, and is based on Ephesians 2:10. It says, "For we are God's masterpiece. He has created us anew in Christ, so we can do the good things He planned for us long ago." Our first song this morning will be Goodness of God, and as we sing this song and praise His name together, let us remember the goodness of God, what He did for us through our lives, and I hope you'll be blessed with it.
Please stand with us.
It's running after me.
this time we will be taking love offering for Milo.
So before we have Mission Trip speak about their testimony, we have a special song for you guys.
Good morning.
Well, happy Sabbath. How have you guys enjoyed the program so far? That's nice, that's nice. Okay, so today I'll be talking a little bit of the mission trip that a little group of students from Milo went on about like 3 weeks ago, if I'm not mistaken. Something along the lines of that. So before we start, I'm gonna open up with a word of prayer. Please bow your heads, close your eyes. Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. Thank you for the fact that we can all come together and worship you. Please bless us and keep us, and just continue to keep us safe throughout the day. And yeah, amen. Okay, so as you can see, on either side of me, there's like four very beautiful pictures of very beautiful people. We see Paul in the top corner, also Pastor Tom, Beatrice, Paul again, and a couple of the students. So before I just talk about all the pictures, I want to say that I don't think this was the first Sabbath we were there. This is like the second one. So first Sabbath we got there. By the time we got in Tanzania, it was late Friday. We went to bed at like 12 something. I couldn't sleep for the whole night, but I think some people did sleep. And then we went to church the next morning on Sabbath. How surprising.
So we went there, and one thing you noticed about the kids is like the school, it's not like the schools here, which was one of the reasons why we're there to help, you know, help the school and stuff like that. But one thing I really noticed about the kids there is that they really, really were like loud with their singing. They were enthusiastic. I'm not sure how you would say this, but they sang like they meant it. How about that? So that was really, really nice to see them being very enthusiastic about the singing and stuff like that. First Sabbath, went through the service. Afterwards, we did a little interaction, and then we got like swarmed by a bunch of kids. They're asking all of us these questions and other stuff, and it was really nice to socially interact with them. So with that being said, I'm gonna start talking about what's happening on this. So I believe that all four of these photos are from the first Sabbath. So yeah, on my right, for this right, Paul's picture, he's playing the drums. He learned how to play the drums pretty good. And then picture next to it, I already said the people, I forgot what we were doing up there. We probably were called up there unannounced. So the headmaster of the place, he was an interesting guy. He was a very funny, nice guy. But he had interesting ways of doing things. He would literally, so let me give you an example. One day, he asked Amber, like, while the service is taking place, it was like we're sitting in this room, people were going up and saying stuff. And he came to Amber, like, a couple minutes before, and he was like, Amber, can you do something? I'm not exactly sure what he said. Well, he said something about his speech, but he said, could she do something? And then, next moment, he's up there saying, now we're gonna have a word from Amber, such and such, such and such. And then he mentioned my name, which was really crazy because he did not even look at me, let alone speak to me. And then he said my name. So he mentioned my name last, so I'm assuming we're gonna go in that order. No, I was the second person to go up there. So yeah, so a lot of the times we're doing like impromptu stuff. You can see in the bottom right corner, it's me, Kylan, and Andrew dancing. That was also a last second thing. He literally went and grabbed us. He went and grabbed us and pulled us up front. And then, yeah, that was a lot of fun, though. And there's Andrew and Matthew singing with a couple of the students. A lot of the students were, like, really nice and talented. They had, like, a very community-like mindset. There's, like, a couple of them. I feel like all of them, honestly, were interested in music quite a bit. There's one named Arnold that was really, really talented and interested in music. So that was nice. So it's nice seeing them so, once again, enthusiastic about something. Yeah, so picture furthest right to me is us helping put windows up. For people on the mission trip, they know that this was a very tedious task. It hurt a lot of people mentally and physically, because sometimes, I think at one point, like half of the group got like sliced by the glass and stuff. So yeah. And then second picture is either on the same day or a couple of days later, where we're helping to mix the paint, so paint the thing. Okay, so before I go any further, we're there for a mission trip to serve people, yes. And to help the school look better, we didn't really do anything regarding the school curriculum or anything itself, but yeah, we did a bunch of construction work, as you have seen already. So we did the glasses, and let me just say the three jobs we did. We put glasses up, we painted a couple walls. I didn't paint, but I put the glasses up and I helped make a floor. And yeah, that's what we did. For like the first week we were there for about 11 days. For the first week we were there, we did that, yeah. So as you can see in the pictures, we had to clear out a room. I think a group of people from our school, Milo, they painted the walls, and then there's like a bunch of trash in the middle, like a lot of trash. So we had to take it out. Right below that picture, you can see that's me, I can tell by my pants, making some glass putty to put on the windows. Then next to that picture, it's one of the students making the concrete. Very nice. Okay, so I think this is where my slide part ends. I gave you a little spoilers. But things I want to say about the whole experience is that they were very, very content in all that they had, all that they did. They had like the schoolwork, you know, they were content with that, even though I would expect they would complain sometimes. But it was nice. They all had like a unified mindset, and they were very, very willing to, I'm not sure how to say this once again, very willing to do things. It was nice seeing like, you know, a group of kids my age be like so bonded with each other as like a community and be so like friendly to us, even though, as I said before, on the first day, they're literally like swarming around us. And we like never even knew them. They're like speaking to us in English and everything. I was like, oh wow, that's crazy. So yeah, I'm gonna go to Amber because she has more to say.
I do have more to say, but tell us, what's your name? Because I think you forgot to do that.
My bad, I forgot my name too. My name is Caden Fubler. Nice to see you guys.
So, fun fact, Caden and I were the only sophomores that went on this mission trip. There was 10 of us, and we are both in grade 10. Everybody else was in grade 11 or were juniors. Now, the next slide, I actually was not planning on talking about this, but it's all right, I can do that. This was basically just the marketplace that we went to get little souvenirs at the very end of our mission trip. This was more of the souvenirs. They did some really pretty glass work in one of the shops that we went to. But what I actually am going to talk about is the safari we went on, because what is a trip to Tanzania, Africa without going on a safari? Now, we went on a safari to two different places. We had a two-day safari, and we went to... Here, wait, let me see if I can pronounce this right. Tarangeti, not Serengeti, which is where most people think of when they think of going on a safari to Tanzania. Went to Tarangeti, and we went to Gorogoro, which is spelled Ngoro Ngoro when I pronounced it like that for quite a little bit. But I'm going to tell you about how we saw the Big Five. Now, the Big Five is five animals that are most common to see in, like, or most, maybe not most common, but most wanted to see. And the Big Five include a lion, a leopard, a water buffalo, a rhino, and an elephant, yes. So, on the first day, we went to the Serengeti. We saw some really, really cool things. Like some of the ones on the bottom, we saw a warthog, we saw a giraffe, and the giraffe was all by itself, which apparently is not very common. But, you know, it was pretty cool. And we saw a monkey in a tree, and I was very excited about the monkey in the tree. Actually, we saw quite a few monkeys in trees. They were kind of mean. We went to eat at their place, and they stole some food from me specifically. But we were on the safari. We were in the safari vehicle, and the safari vehicle, you could stand up in it, and there was the wind that would be coming. My hair would get all super tousled, which actually I won't do that. My mom is in the room. She might get mad at me. And we saw some pretty cool animals. I was super excited. I've never been on a safari before, and I was just like, wow, this is so cool. We've seen a warthog. We've seen all these different, like, there was a bunch of zebras that we saw, and I was like, we were only an hour in. I was like, this is crazy. And then our driver, he started speeding up. And we could tell he started speeding up because the wind started getting a lot faster and things started moving a lot faster. And I was like, I don't know why we're speeding up, but it was a fun ride. We were having fun, we were bouncing, and we were going, woo! And it was a lot of fun. And I asked my dad, I remember, I was like, why are we going so much faster? And he was like, well, whenever a tour guide whenever when you're going on a safari, they start going faster. That means that they've seen something super cool, and they want to take you to see something super cool. That's when we went to see the cheetahs. Now, cheetahs, they are not part of the big five, but they are super rare to see. Our tour guide said that people see them, like he, as a tour guide, only sees them once every 3 to 4 months, which is crazy. And we got there right about as they were leaving. They were there for maybe like a minute before they were gone. And this is one of the pictures I got of them. They were super close, and we saw them super cool. It was amazing. And I was like, wow, we're already 1 minute into the safari, and we've already seen such a cool thing. And then we ended up leaving. We were just kind of going around. The tour guide, he was listening to the video. He was like, not the video. They have a walkie-talkie. The tour guides have walkie-talkies. They use to interact with each other to tell them, hey, something cool is happening over on this side of the safari or whatever, right? And so he's just kind of listening to that. We're just kind of chilling, going around, looking at all the different trees. We haven't really seen any animals after the cheetah, when suddenly he starts speeding up again. And when he starts speeding up, we're like, okay, we're about to see something super cool. And now I don't have a picture of it on this slide because I didn't get a great picture of it, but we ended up seeing a leopard. Now a leopard is the first one of the big five. And so I was like, oh wow. And leopards, they're not easy to see either. And I was like, that's so, so cool. This is crazy. We're seeing some of the really cool animals. And then later on, we started speeding up again. And I was like, okay, we're seeing something super cool again. And that's when we saw the elephant. Now this elephant, we were there for like a good 30 minutes, let me tell you. Because that elephant, it was so cool. It was just standing there. It was eating, and then it started walking over to this side and eating on this side, because I think that's all elephants do is walk and eat. I don't know. I mean, I'd be very happy if all I had to do in life was walk and eat. But yeah, after we finished seeing the elephant, we were doing our thing, and we left the park. And we went to our hotel, or I don't know if it was technically a hotel. I think it was a hotel. And we went to the next place, the Goro Goro Crater. The Goro Goro Crater, the first one of the big five that we saw, was the water buffalo. In fact, we weren't even inside the Goro Goro Crater when we saw the water buffalo. We were, because you have to go up on the top, and then you have to go back down into the crater to see the water, to go into the crater, right? And we saw the first water buffalo, the one that is on your left side, on the way to the thing. And I was like, that is so cool. And one of the guys in our tour thing told us that these are actually the most dangerous of the big five. They hurt the most people. And so it was kind of apprehensive, but I was like, you know, it's cool. That's three of the big five. And I was like, are we gonna be able to see all of the big five? But the tour guide told us that it's not very likely that people see all the big five, especially the rhino. The rhino is the hardest and the most difficult to see. So I was like, oh yeah, we'll not see the entire big five. And so as we went on, we saw a lion, which was super, super cool. We saw four lions, two males and two females. And we saw some hippos. We didn't get to see them out of the water because most of the time, if you go during the day, hippos don't often come out of the water. But after we, let me back up. So we were in the Goro Goro Crater for a while. We saw some really cool animals. We saw some zebras. We saw a whole bunch of gazelle. We saw some flamingos that were not pink. So it made me very sad that they were not like the little lawn thingies. They weren't that pink. They were just white, basically. They were kind of pinkish, but it was whatever. And by the end of the day, I was really tired. It had been a long day. It had been a good day, but it had been a long day. And I was kind of sleeping. Oh, I forgot to tell you. We did end up seeing a rhino. I didn't get a picture of the rhino because it was super far away, but we did end up seeing a rhino. The big five, which, crazy. Apparently, the tour guide said, that's not common at all. For the places that we went, it's not common for most people to see the big five. But this elephant has a very, very cool story. Because we were in the car, we were tired. I remember in my car specifically, one of the of guys had a ukulele, and he was serenading us with his beautiful voice and his beautiful ukulele playing skills. He was doing amazing. Good job, good job. But I was getting sleepy. I was like, I'm just gonna maybe close my eyes. And then I hear my dad, who, my dad is the pastor, and he was the one who helped organize the trip. I hear my dad say, stop, stop, go back, go back. There was an elephant on the road, okay? And mind you, we are in the middle of a highway. And so I was like, an elephant? Here? We've already left the place where the safari is. We've already left the crater. We're not in Serengeti anymore. What do you mean an elephant? And so our driver, he started backing up. One of the guys in my car, he was like, you didn't see an elephant, Pastor. I think that maybe you're just tired and your eyes are playing tricks on you. And then Paul, the guy who's going to come up next, he was like, it's all right, Pastor. I believe in you. And sure enough, we saw an elephant, okay? And this elephant was so close to our thing. It was probably like from here to the back of the room. Maybe, I don't know. I'm really bad with distances. But that's a good distance. Yeah, it was really, really close to us. And it was so cool. And I remember thinking as we went home, I was like, this safari, it's amazing. The things that we did, the animals that we saw, this is more of the elephant from the other car's perspective, because there was two cars, because I think there was only six seats per car. And it made me think, like, wow, what a wonderful God. He made all of these different things, right? He made the elephant. He made the lion, the leopard, the rhino, the water buffalo. He made all of that different stuff. And he let us see all of it. He was there. It must have been a God thing for us to be able to see the cheetah and the big five. That's not something that most tour groups do. And it made me think, you know, that was a real blessing. And whenever I get into a time where maybe I don't see God's blessings as much, I don't feel his presence as much, maybe I can learn to be content. Maybe I can learn to remember the times that he did bless. Because, I mean, it's not a huge deal to be able to see the big five. I mean, it is a huge deal. I think it's a big deal. But it's not like a necessity, you know? It's not like we're praying for our food, you know, or whatever our needs. Seeing the big five is not a need. But it was something that was super cool. And I think that God really did bless. And now I'm going to give it over to Paul, our resident Paul.
Thank you. Thank you, Amber. Okay. Let me give it back to you. Perfect. So I'm here to talk about how we saw God working through this whole mission trip. And like Amber said, a lot of things that weren't supposed to happen, happened. And we really saw God's presence, you know, from the little things as losing earbuds, to losing batteries for cameras, to feeding over 80 kids with candy. God really provided for all of us. And at first, there was complication for the safari, and we didn't know if we would be able to make it. And so the Pastor Tom, her dad, he was like, hey guys, let's pray, and please pray throughout the day, because we might not make it. And so some of us prayed, I know Andrew prayed, and like 5 minutes later, like he received an email saying that everything went well, thanks to Mrs. Amy and everybody involved. And the money was transferred to a different bank because that's what needed to be done. And so praise God that we made it through the safari and now we can tell you fun stories about animals. But throughout this mission trip, there was three verses that kept on coming back. And I think it's like a theme. And the theme is this. God has your back and he's actively working to help you. Philippians 4, verse 4. Rejoice always. I say unto you again, rejoice always. The kids there, like Kaden mentioned, they were like the happiest people I actually ever saw in my life. Like, they look at you, they have a smile on their face. Like, every time you look at them, if they're not working, and even if they're working, they have a smile, they're always making jokes, having fun with each other. And it really touched my heart a lot. The second verse is Philippians 4, verse 6. Do not be anxious of anything, but pray for all things while giving thanks. Like I mentioned, a lot of things weren't always going right. And a lot of the time we think of mission trips, we always know that God will work powerfully. Well, for God to work powerfully, that means there needs to be a problem. There needs to be a dilemma. There needs to be confrontation. And so when those things do come, it's just an opportunity for God to show his power. Amen. And so we should be able to try to not be anxious, even though I often do. Try to not be anxious, pray, and thank God for all the good things that he did, all the blessings that we had. And the final one is Philippians 4, verse 11. I learned to be content in all things. The kids there, like I said, were the happiest kids I ever saw. And they probably didn't have as much as, even, they probably had a hundredth of possessions that anyone here has. So they were really like, they weren't the richest at all. Like, mm-mm. But yet, they were so happy. They were content. They were really content. And so contentment is not about what you have or who you think you are or who, well, if you think you're God's son, then it does help. But it's not about who you think you are or your friends or the achievements you did in your life. Contentment is a choice. It's a mindset. And so those three verses. And just, I would like to encourage you guys. First, do not be anxious about anything, but pray for everything. God helped us out throughout this whole thing. The simple fact of us going to the mission trip already in itself was a miracle. Because not everybody has that much money to spend whenever they want. And also, I don't know if you all knew it, but I'm not an American. I'm an international student. So when I was coming back to America, well, there was just complications. They pulled me aside. They were trying to, you know, they didn't really know what to do with me. They were like, should we send him back? Should he stay? They didn't know. And I knew it before. I was praying in the plane. Like, my dad told me before, like, if you leave America, just know you're going to have problems coming back in. And I was like, in the plane from Amsterdam to USA, I was just freaking out. I was like, God, please help me out. Please help me out. And then I tried to stay as, like, I tried to not be anxious and pray for all things and thank you, God, for all the good stuff. And we arrived to the U.S. They checked our passports. They pulled Kaden and I aside. Kaden didn't really have a big problem, though. They just needed to check something. Me, though, on the other hand, it was a 50-50 chance of going back. So that was a fun experience, really. I enjoy it. Not going to do it again, though. That's why, yeah, I wouldn't recommend doing that. But it was worth it. God really helped us out. And I saw that God really wanted me to be there because he helped me come back. So I want to leave you with this. Do not be anxious about anything. Pray for everything. Thank God for the good, the bad, the ugly, all these things. Because there is a reason why. And I guess the fourth verse, all things work together for the good of those who love God and who were called according to his purpose. Romans 8:28, my favorite verse. So remember that the good, the bad, all these things, God let it happen so he can use them to not only help us, but bless other people. I think we went there, we did good things to them, and they did good things to us. But those things are going to help not only us, but them, and who knows, maybe their whole nation or our nation. So yeah, rejoice always. Don't be anxious. Pray for everything. Thank God for everything. Know that God has your back and he's actively working to help you out. Amen. God bless you.
Oh, there we go. Thank you very much. Wow, wasn't that beautiful? Whoo, you have blessed us. Thank you so much. That was just a breath of fresh air this morning. We just appreciate what you brought and what you shared. You did an excellent job. Thank you so, so much. Can we thank them one more time, church? Such a beautiful way to spend the Sabbath. Thank you so much. All right, well, we're gonna have food. Anybody excited about that idea? All right. They've worked up an appetite, so go ahead. We are gonna go over into the other room. We're gonna enjoy that fellowship together. Let's pray before we go, real quick though. We'll pray for quick. Psych, right? Lord Jesus, thank you so much for these awesome students, Lord, from Milo. Lord, I pray you'd give them a rich blessing today as they have blessed us. Lord, bless the food, and Lord, I pray you'd bless our fellowship and our company together and the rest of this Sabbath. And Lord, we just love you and so grateful for your love for us and that you always have our back and looking out after us all the time. Lord, we love you in Jesus' name. Amen. Happy Sabbath. You are dismissed.